Hi, I'm Alison Morrow with your DNR report. It's not always easy to see, but if you look closely under this bark, there's a tiny insect that can cause such big problems, it can be lethal for trees.
Once a beetle attacks a tree, they emit a pheromone called an aggregation pheromone, and that basically just tells all their buddies to come to the party, and they bore tunnels under the bark into the cambium layer that cuts off circulation and essentially girdles the tree.
The pine engraver beetle is most attracted to downed green trees, like after a storm, or recently cut and placed into slash piles. That's why the Department of Natural Resources is conducting an experiment to manage its destruction. The experiment will take place in 7 counties around eastern Washington. Trees will be chopped into piles. A pheromone will be attached to attract the beetles to attack the wood.
Once the firewood piles are attacked, we will be covering 1 of 2 piles that are at each site with 6 mil clear plastic in an attempt to try and cook them, and we will be leaving them covered for 30 days. And then after 30 days, we will come back and we will count bugs to see what the mortality rate was in the covered versus non-covered.
This study was conducted in Arizona years ago, and it was successful, but we don't know if it would be successful here in eastern Washington. It's hotter and drier in Arizona, and we're not sure if the temperatures beneath the plastic will be able to reach 113 degrees and be sustained long enough to kill pine engraver and slash.
If it works, experts say using plastic covering to kill the beetles will offer landowners a better alternative without the wildfire risk that comes with burning the wood.
And many landowners don't have access to things like chippers or masticators, so polyethylene plastic is easy to use. You can get it at most hardware stores, and you can also use it year-round.
A tool like this would be very beneficial to landowners that maybe don't understand how bark beetles work and create the prime feeding and breeding material on their property. And so when we come out and can show, you know, hey, you have bark beetles and some of your firewood here, here's a tool that you can use to try and kill them before they hatch and attack more of your standing trees.
The results of the experiment should be available by next year.